EA Sports to the game.
We're off to France for today's Grand Slam Classic as we relive the 2007 French Open Women's Final between Justine Henin and Ana Ivanovic. Let's pick up the action in the first set with Henin off to a quick start, up by 5-1.
And I'm going to do something. Okay, good.
And here we are, another game. Backhand winner, she is something else.
Obviously, there's a need to make your opponent get on the move and to challenge their fitness level, right, Pat?
Oh, absolutely. You've got to make your opponent move. You've got to test out their strengths and their weaknesses. You've got to see how quick they are, see if they get there, what their agility is like. And it's the only way, really, to get to the weakness is to find one of the strengths and then hit it back the other side.
This is the first break point of the match.
Well, it just goes to show how well that she's defended her serve over the course of this set. Well, she's in big trouble here. Double break point. Underrated shot in tennis. Go the long way, right across court and backwards and forwards across court. Well, that certainly gave her patience, but if you want to hit the winner, you go smack it quickly down the line. Get another game for her here. Settling in for the second serve. What a perfect shot. And a half.
The pros and cons of hitting the shots deep. The pros are you give your opponent less time to come over the pass and less confidence that they'll be able to do something with it. The cons, none.
Shot, backhand winner. Even though there's trouble on the scoreboard, I like to see a good fight. She's had a pleasure winning. Hit that for a clean winner.
Game point now.
Key shot of play to me is a topspin, the use of topspin with these grips, Western grips they call them, open stances, which is tough to tell where the ball is going, and of course it's slow and kicks up high. That allows this topspin to be more effective than it would be in another surface and more devastating to a guy who's looking to be aggressive.
What was he thinking? Smacked it away, no problem.
All right, John. You know your opponent's got a weakness, which is somehow you can't seem to get there. You can't seem to beat him. What's the option to do?
Well, give him credit for masking it, but give him credit for minimizing it and running around it. You've got to open up the court a little bit so that weakness is exposed and easier to attack. That's when you move in for the kill. A good play for a strategy also is to pull your opponent off the court with a short angle ball, followed by a two-fisted back and rip it up the line.
Really must get underneath that touchscreen shot. And his first serve is crucial.
Usually what you do is you start to try to serve harder, go for closer to the line, and that's what her opponent's doing there.
She's putting too much into it, you think?
A little bit too much, getting out of her element there, not in the comfort zone, and that's because of the return game there. Excellent break to serve.
Well, she's about to serve the start of the game. Dumping forehand into the backhand corner. Here. Oh, she's got that. Cross court winner.
You play a good close game at your home. I think there's a good momentum swing there, puts the pressure back on the opponent. That's more important maybe than it even looked that game.
Another big point here for it.
She can hold here, she can take this to a tiebreaker. Well, easier said than done.
Thank you.
Might take a risk here on that serve.
crucial, don't you think?
I always used to like to play ahead much more than I did behind. That goes without saying, but some people can come back a lot better and fight back from deficits. So if you're a good front runner, what you try to do is do something special early on in the set. And that's what you did there. That's well done. Okay, the player is looking for a strong service game here to consolidate the break and really take control of this match.
Oh, beautifully timed. She hit that for an absolute winner. Crucial on the second serve.
Just having been broken. This would be huge right here. She could get the break back.
Points absolutely crucial to get the serve in. Work this second serve well. She's hit the double fault. That's not good. Probably thinking she might take a risk on this serve. Really have to get down low to get that volley over the net. There is too many unforced errors going on in this match. What's going to happen to the outcome, John?
Oh, that could be the difference between winning and losing. Let's face it, I'd love to play an opponent who made a lot of unforced errors. That was like, thank you very much, I will take that.
Yes, please.
And the key then is to continue to play high percentage tennis and allow your opponent to beat himself.
That's what she said, was it? What a winner. What kind of ball is that? Smash it away easy.
big lead he's got now. Two games. He's certainly favourite to win this set now.
And we're starting up yet again. Necessary for it. Oh, that's gone into the net. Oh, it just didn't get underneath that spin. Crucial break point, serve has to be accurate.
Well, every guy has managed to get through it. Maybe it's the argument for no way of scoring. The first to four. We get a little too complicated in tennis, but I think the drama is there. It makes it exciting. I like that. Too sad.
And here we are back again. game point now.
There's a momentum swing here.
And they're about to start this game. Telescopic arms or something to get that one back. Well, she can get out of this game with a good serve here.
Serving for the match, you've got yourself in a great position, but serving, particularly in a women's game, doesn't mean that the match is over.
Well, certainly a lot of breaks, that's for sure. And I don't know about you, but I always felt the heart rate started going about twice as fast as we had a chance to finish off the match. But you know your opponent's a little bit down, so if you keep this focus at one point at a time, you're in a great position here.
He's got match point and serving.
Rule number one, I think, when you go out there, of course you're going to be nervous, you're going to be shaking a bit, and perhaps you're going to throw out a couple of double faults and unforced errors, but she never really made her opponent work that way. And that's when she goes back to the locker room and looks at the tape later on, and she's going to be really disappointed in herself.
Well, that's about all we had at the lovely French Open in Port Phillip Chatrier. Alongside John McEnroe, this is Pat Cash saying goodbye for now.